Can you ladies hear me? Can you hear me?
Yes, I can.
Awesome. And I can hear you. Great. Awesome. So we're going to tell a little bird and welcome to Babes on Blab. I am Amethyst Wildfire, and I want to share with you that this is a little vision that just popped for me a few weeks ago, and I am so excited and delighted to have Allison and Laura with me today to be the inaugural first episode Babes on Blab on business and success, and particularly on pioneering. So we also have people who are waiting to join us in the additional seat, but first we're going to do some interviewing with Allison and Laura. And before we start with that, let me just introduce myself. I will introduce myself, my guests, and today's topic, and tell you a little bit more about the Babes on Blab vision. So I'm Amethyst Wildfire with the empoweredmessenger.com. That's the business that I fly under right now. And you can find me over there if you're interested in finding out more about who I am and what I do. But just to give you a little bit of background, I spent over 20 years in the real estate industry, and at the end of that career had managed over $100 million in real estate assets. And I also built a multifamily, multi-use community at the very end of that career and was the national chairperson for my trade association. Then I had a spiritual awakening and changed my name, became a shaman, and became a supporter and empowerer of other women who are going through spiritual changes to be able to find their voice and claim their value and share their message with the world. And so here we are today with Babes on Blab, and what I'm really excited about is that this is a platform that's going to allow women entrepreneurs to and visionaries and experts in a variety of areas to share their wisdom, to really be seen, to shine bright, and to share their wisdom and their deep insight. And so I'm super honored that I have two guests today who are just sisters of my heart, who are going to be sharing with us today on business and success. And we are going to be doing this broadcast every other Wednesday at 1 o'clock. We have 13 episodes scheduled. The next episode is going to be on spirituality. So for those of you who are spiritual folk, we'd love to have you join us there. So let me just introduce Allison first. Allison is right over here. Say hi and wave, Allison. If you want to follow Allison, just press on the little plus button next to her name, and you can follow her. If you want to tell a little bird over on the left, you can tell a little bird, meaning you can share with your Twitter followers that we are blabbing today. And Allison is a spiritual entrepreneur, internationally known for revealing untapped revenue opportunities in service-based businesses. After 20 years in the corporate world, Allison left her six-figure senior management position and put her talents to work as an entrepreneur. Her success has been featured on CNN, CBS, ABC, NBC, Fox, The Wall Street Journal, and other national media. She was also featured on the cover of People You Need to Know magazine and Women's Essence magazine. God, you are just a rockin' awesome babe, Allison. She was the host of the Business Transformation Show, where she provided a unique blend of mindset shifting, spirit renewing, and revenue accelerating strategies, helping entrepreneurs to unleash their success from the inside out. And I have known Allison now for a few years. We met on social media. And one of the things that I want to share about Allison that I know is not necessarily in the written bio, but is definitely something that I know about her. Her success is directly tied to her connection with her source and her source of inspiration. And she is truly an embodied spiritual entrepreneur who follows her guidance in bringing her wisdom to the world, in sharing her gifts, in guiding the people that she is here to guide. And it is such a pleasure to have you here, Allison. Welcome. And I'm going to introduce Laura, and then we're going to, I'm going to ask each of you to comment a little bit on some things that I think that we need to talk about pioneering in business and success. So Laura and I have known one another for many years. We have shared many sacred spaces with each other, both virtually and live. And she's a passion and creativity strategist and mentor coach. She's helped thousands of entrepreneurs discover their passion platform, using their passion, creativity, and unique brilliance to create successful businesses that make a difference in the world. She's the author and creator of dozens of information products, teleclasses, and workshops, and is a highly sought-after speaker for conferences, telesummits, and workshops. She's also the author of the popular Joyful Business Guide, a creative marketing plan. And in her 20-year corporate life as a VP of marketing for a Fortune 500 company in the shopping center industry, she developed creative ideas and turned them into multi-center events, sales-enhancing programs, and major grand openings. She was considered an innovative leader in developing sales tracking and producing programs. So you can find out more about Laura and about Allison on their websites right now. So Blab is a platform that is a beta. So it's in the beta. So as you can see, all of a sudden we now have poor internet signal with Allison and with Laura. So ladies, you might want to drop out and come back in again. Or we might just go with audio. I'm not sure exactly how well this is going to work. It is a brand new platform. We are experimenting. So we're going to do the best that we can do here with what we have. And I'm going to actually ask Laura, why don't Laura, you drop off and come back in again. And I will say hello to Allison for a moment. And then I'll see if we can get Allison to drop off and come back in again, and we can maybe get video. And if not, we're just going to go with audio. All will be well. So first, let me say hi and thank you, Allison. Thank you so much for being here and for saying yes to the experiment. And I'd love to first off ask you your website and also ask you for some opening thoughts on business and success, and specifically on pioneering.
So I'm live, right?
Can you hear me? Can you hear me, Allison?
Me talking, okay, but I hear you too.
So yeah, we're gonna have to have you come back in again, Allison. We're gonna have to have you come back in again. All right, we got Laura. We got Laura. Okay, so again, this is totally an experiment. Thank you for playing with me, ladies. We're going to do the best that we can. We've got Laura, and we're going to see if Allison can come back in and be on the video. So Laura, I'd love to have you introduce yourself just briefly. Like, tell us your website. Give us just a few sound bites on your thoughts about business and success, and specifically about pioneering, because what we're doing right here is we are totally pioneering and we are in beta land. And I'd love to hear, you know, just one sentence or two about your thoughts about being a pioneer, because I've known you for many years and you are a pioneer in bringing creativity into business on the web. So I'd love to hear your thoughts.
Great. Thanks, Amethyst. And yes, what a great pilot. I love that we're pioneering all together. my business is the Center for Joyful Business at joyfulbusiness.com. And pioneering, yeah, I've been thinking about this as we've been just going back and forth over the last week, you know, thinking about this idea of pioneering. And you know, it's very interesting. But one of the things, I mean, I know we'll get into a lot, but one thing I just wanted to bring into our conversation is that when you are a pioneer, you tend to surround yourself with other pioneers. And then all of a sudden, it feels like everybody is innovative and creative and is a pioneer. And you kind of forget, like, 99% of the rest of the world is not like that. and, you know, it takes them a while to come with you. You know, that pioneering, you know, if you think about the covered wagons and pioneers in this, you know, this country, in America, at least, you know, that's kind of a lonely expedition. You know, you're often out there alone for a while. And then others catch up. And then, you know, I know we'll talk a lot more, but then you're on to the next pioneering thing.
Yes, you are. And here we are pioneering together. Thank you, Laura. Yeah, thank you. So Allison, could you just give us your website where people can find you and a little bit about your business and about pioneering? Because one of the things that I, you know, one of the things that you and I did together was you did a pioneering telesummit about a year and a half ago, and it was really powerful and potent, and the message that you brought through was powerful there. So go take it away, Allison.
Well, like you, Amethyst, my views on business and success comes from a spiritual awakening that I had 2 years ago. And if anyone wants to hear what that story is all about, you can go to AllisonPhillips.tv and type in spiritual journey, and my story is there. But that spiritual awakening gave birth to a lot of pioneering things in my life. The first was the summit on how to create wealth without goal setting. That was when I myself was searching for an entirely different way to be in the world, because that spiritual awakening, when I experienced it, caused me, couldn't do business in the same way ever again. I couldn't go back to the old Allison. Once you wake up, you kind of like, okay, I'm in a new world now. There's no going back anymore. So that was my first really effort with pioneering something that will seem really strange, because all of the people that I interviewed on that Wealth Without Goal Setting Summit were people who were creating 6, 7, up to 9 figures in revenue, not goal setting and not doing the rigid goal setting, big marketing plans, all these different things. So that was really eye-opening for me. Very close to that experience, I felt like I needed an entirely different way to embrace marketing, because all that I had learned about marketing just didn't fit with the life experience and the spiritual experience that I was having at the time. And then one day in a meditation, I had this come to me, this concept of awakened marketing and a way to do marketing such that it is actually not for making anything happen, but it is for really helping you to get marketing, the purpose of marketing being not to make anything happen, but to get you into the vibration that allows things to happen. So a very different perspective on marketing. And I kept looking around to see who else is teaching it so I could go like her, like him. And then I realized, okay, so I'm supposed to pioneer this. So I'm just going to go forth and pioneer it. So my website is greatsmallbusinessadvice.com. My videos are on AllisonPhillips.tv, and my daily show on Periscope, thanks to you, Amethyst, for leading the way on that. My daily show on Periscope is at thebusinesstransformationshow.com.
Beautiful. So what I'd like you ladies to do, Laura and Allison, is type into the chat your URLs so people can get with you. And while you're doing that, I'm going to take a short moment to get some earplugs to see if I can hear you better. Go. Let's see if I can hear you better, because I've heard that sometimes it's better to use the earplugs that you can hear better. So I'm going to plug in here, and we're going to thank everybody who is watching for all of your incredible patience. All right, so Laura or Allison, say something for me. Okay, I can hear myself. Can you hear me?
I can hear you.
Okay, I can hear you great now.
Laura, okay. I can hear you.
I can hear everybody great now. Yay. Okay, that's good. So this is us a learning. Wear earplugs when you're hosting. Awesome. All right. So ladies, I have 3 different things that I want to talk about pioneering. And I also want to bring in somebody into the seat here to get a hot seat. So either to get a hot seat or to share their message, share something that they want to share about business and success and pioneering. But before I do that, I want to give a little short commercial break for Babes on Blab TV. I would love to have anybody who's interested in keeping up with what we're blabbing about, what our next episode is going to be. When it's going to be airing.
You froze.
Oh, I froze. Okay.
You're good.
Okay. So anybody who is interested can go to babesonblab.com to find out, to get signed up to our list, because we're going to have a list that we are going to be letting people know when the blabs are. It's also a place where you can, if you want to donate to support the cause, to bring more babes on Blab and to expand and grow this as this platform expands and grows. We'd love to have you come on over there and get on our list, support us, make donations, or if you'd like, become a member of our community. So that's our short commercial break. Now, I have 3 things that I have found that
people do when they are not willing to allow that pioneering spirit to lead them. One of the things that I see that they do is they look at everybody else as competition. One of the things I see they do is that they look at everybody else and compare themselves to everybody else. And one of the things I see them do is they try to camouflage. They put themselves in a cookie cutter and camouflage who they really are to fit in. And it's really by standing out that we can actually make the difference. So I'd like to talk to you, each of you, about these three topics, about how you have found yourself either transiting out of these stuck places, or how you might help other people to relieve themselves of this. So let's start with competition. And who would like to go first, Allison or Laura? Who would like to go first?
I'll go first, that's fine. Well, I think in the place that I am in life right now, I don't see competition as anything other than energy in the world that allows you to see all that as possible, because we are all unique, we're all different, we're all doing things in different ways. And competition is somebody who's doing something like me, but that can, for me, the way I see it is somebody who's doing something like me, but that can be a real source of a positive energy for what is possible. So I don't any longer see that as a negative thing. I think everybody around us can be considered as competition, but if we see it for what it is, it's people, look at all these people doing all these different things, kind of like me, but kind of different. Let me go see what they're doing so I could be inspired and I can be, and I can see all that's possible. If they're way more successful than me, then I could like hype up my vibe and in the direction of, oh, cause if they're there, then certainly I can get there too, because they're a human being just like I am. So to me, if you receive it more as impetus to actually allow you to expand even more, then you don't really see it as competition in the way that the world sees it.
Mm-hmm. Beautiful. Thank you, Allison. So Laura, I'm gonna ask you to speak about this, but I'm also going to open up the third seat here. Hopefully we can stabilize this. And we have somebody here, Cammie Baker, from our audience here. And Cammie also happens to be a client of mine who is stepping into her role as a leader. And so Cammie, hopefully we can get you to come in and come on. And if that's not gonna work, then we will have you drop off and come back in again and ask to be to join the seat. So Laura, I would love to hear from you about competition, how it has shown up for you, maybe in your past, how you might have transcended being in the energy of feeling like you were competing, or if you never had that issue, you know, if you've always stayed true to your pioneering ways.
Oh yeah, never been bothered by competition. You know, I think when we are really, what I've noticed is when I'm really grounded, when I am really aligned with what I'm doing, it's very easy to look around and feel like everybody is a big collaborator in the world, you know, that we're all doing our share, doing our piece. And then there's days where, you know, you didn't get enough sleep, or maybe you're really expanding in something big and, you know, your confidence might be a little new, you know, that courage muscle hasn't been built up yet. So, you know, sometimes you do get like tweaked by things that somebody's putting out, and people put out such brilliant things. And so every now and then you're like, wow, I should have done that, or I could have done that, or I thought of that 2 years ago, I should have moved on it. And one of the things that has really helped me to reframe that is whenever that happens and I see something that somebody's doing that's really brilliant, and I have that little voice that says, oh, you should be doing that, or, you know, I'd like to do something like that, I call them my trigger mentor, that they are my trigger mentor. And to me, they are there to mentor me. You know, they have a message and it's triggering something in me. So whenever I get that trigger, I say there's a message, and it just means that they've got a piece of something that is already inside me that really wants to come out. And so it's, you know, just that little reminder that they're here to mentor me. They're a mirror for me of maybe how I want my creativity to come out, or I love the colors on their website, or what a cool way to put that free report together, or, oh, I love how Amethyst is doing that blab and I want to do a blab, you know. But it's, to me, it's like, if you can look at how they're mentoring you through that little trigger, then you can kind of sail through it and you say, that's just the message for me. And that's what I most need to learn.
Nice. Beautiful. I like that. So I agree with you both. I think that it's awesome and important for us as pioneers to be gathering inspiration from as many inspiring people as we can. And I would agree with you that, Laura, that there are plenty of people out there that are triggering for me as well. And so I want to kind of just follow on to that about how you manage to also, as a pioneer, stay true and stay grounded in your own vision. Because sometimes what I found can happen is I get triggered and then I'm like off running in directions that may start to dilute my presence and my power and my impact. So can you talk a little bit about that, Laura? And then we'll ask Allison to talk. And I seem to be having trouble, Cami, getting you on. So I don't know what we're going to do about that, but maybe we're going to have you try and re-come on again one more time. So we're going to open that seat. And so Laura, tell me about the distractor factor. Does that ever happen for you?
As an innovator and a creative type? Oh. yeah. So it's incredibly, incredibly important for me to be aware of that and to manage that the distractions, you know. And what I notice is there's a point where I do look at a lot of things because I'm such an innovator and I get filled up. And I have to notice when I'm full and then when I hit that tipping point where it's more of a distraction, where it actually starts getting me ungrounded. And that's when I know it's time to, you know, go off to some creative cafe time, do my mind maps, read a little spiritual journal, you know, spiritual book and do some journaling, you know, go for a walk in the woods. Like those practices are invaluable. And I think the more that you are innovative, creative, and a pioneer, and the more successful you get, the more critical those practices become, because you absolutely need those to keep your feet on the ground with your, you know, your head in the clouds type of thing.
Beautiful. 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 Yeah, I talk about that with my clients. I talk about being mountain, you know, deeply rooted in the earth and yet reaching for the stars. And
yes,
I have also found myself that the deeper I am able to ground myself in the earth of my being, right? The more potent and focused I'm actually able to become. And I can also become more intentional, like about how I am going to share my wisdom, how I am going to express myself in the world. So Allison, tell me about your thoughts about the, you know, the gazillion ways that we can be distracted when we're pioneers, and how you manage to keep yourself deeply rooted in the mother and yet reaching for the stars.
Well, there's no shortage of distractions, whether you're a pioneer or not. But I think for me, it's very much like Laura, is just having a lot of, I am a fan of a tremendous amount of stillness, and I do it in many ways. Certainly I have my meditation in the morning. I always go out for walks in the park in the morning. But my entire day is punctuated with stillness. And a lot of times people go, well, I'll do my meditation in the morning or at night. But for me, I have to have stillness throughout the day. So in between appointments, there's a little lake outside my house and the back of my house is very green and luscious. And so I will take breaks in between client appointments or in between whatever it is I'm doing. And I'll go just appreciate nature. Oh, I'll go just sit and be still for a minute or two. And it doesn't have to be like a 20-minute meditation or anything, but I make sure that my entire day is punctuated. Sometimes stillness comes for me in a moment where I just stop everything, like right here at my desk, I'll pull back and stop everything. and just remind myself of who I truly am. I'm not the projects that I'm running. I'm not the list that I'm growing. I'm not the business that I'm running. I'm not the mother that I'm not any of those things. I'm way more than that. I'm a spiritual being, a profoundly spiritual being in a human body. And I try to remind myself of that many times during the day, especially when we can get sucked into some kind of project or activity or things to do. I look for those moments where it's in between appointments, it's in between things, or even if I'm working on a project, I take quick breaks and I go, remember who you are, girlfriend, you're not any of this. You're not any of these things that you're doing. And my entire day is punctuated with a lot of stillness. My son, who was home with me for quite a bit when I was homeschooling him, he said, are you actually working? Because you spend a lot of time out on the deck staring at trees. I do work, but I spend a lot of time in stillness as well. So in between appointments, I'm never in my office. I go out in nature, even if it's to just go out on my deck and look up at the sky and just connect with nature a little bit. For me, that's how I keep myself grounded and how I keep, because of my spiritual awakening that I had a couple years ago, when I feel distraction, I can feel that energy drain almost instantly. And I know what that feels like. And so the minute I feel it, I can go, okay, time to go into stillness, time to back it up a little bit. So that's how I back it up.
Beautiful. I love that. Back it up. So I'm going to see if Cammy, can you talk and maybe we can hear you because we're not seeing you. Okay. Again, this is totally an experiment. We're doing the best that we can here with the technology, brand new technology. Cammy, maybe one of the things you might need to do is have your computer access your audio and video. And I'm not sure how to make that happen. So anyway, she's trying to come in and that's good. You know, we're giving it our best shot, You just spoke. Okay, so we didn't hear you, Cammy. So I think for you, you might want to just double check to make sure that your video and audio is functioning on your computer. So I'm going to drop you off and I'm going to, we're going to take another little short commercial break here. So the first thing I want to say is thank you, thank you, thank you. Look at all the people who are here blabbing with us, with the Babes on Blab. Yay! I'm so excited. We have all these people at the top of the screen. So ladies, Allison and Laura, if there's anybody up there at the top of the screen that you are excited about connecting with, you might want to just click on them. Hold on, my phone's ringing.
Can you click on?
Wasn't expecting a phone call, so hopefully we can make that stop. We're going to just hang them right up. Okay, whoever that was is off now. Anyway, note to self, shut off phone before Babes on Blab TV starts.
I can see the checklist is forming.
The checklist is forming. So for those of you who are watching, who are up across the top, you can click on each other's faces and you can follow one another here on Blab. You can also over to the left-hand side of your screen, you can go ahead and tell a little bird. So you can share with your Twitter family that we are blabbing here on all these babes are blabbing here today about business success and particularly about pioneering. And we are going to not talk to you right now. So you have to stop. Let me see if I can shut the phone off here. Initial setting, select, ringer setting, select, volume, down, off, save.
Yeah, this is one of those moments off. Where we just need to breathe and connect and we can be present while you manage
nice
your phone.
Nice deep breath, nice deep breath. Okay, great. So now let's talk about Babes on Blab. Babesonblab.com is where you can go if you want to find out more about this particular show, if you want to sign up for our list so that you can get replays, if you want to sign up to be part of our community, if you would like to donate, we'd love to have you donate to support the cause of bringing more babes onto Blab. I have a massive vision for this. Like this is this is just the beginning, ladies, and I am seeing so many threads weaving together, so many collaborations that are potentially possible, and so many beautiful things that can blossom out of this. And I am a channel for spirit, and this is, I'm going to call this Archangel Michael and the Angels Party, because however it unfurls from here is going to be a divine, divine unfurling. So we're going to let the divine unfurl it, and I will continue to say yes as I am guided. I would love to talk now, ladies, about comparing ourselves to others and how that can really throw a wrench into the pioneering energy. And what you maybe guide your people to do when you're working with them, your particular clients to do when you're working with them, and they start playing the comparing themselves to other people game, or comparing, maybe even sometimes comparing themselves to you. I've had clients that are comparing themselves to me, and you know, I know for me, I've had many years of experience doing many things, and when my clients come to me, they're coming to me specifically because I can help them in certain areas where they're needing support. And so when they start to compare themselves to me, one of the things that I, you know, really have to work with them on is like, no, please don't do that, because you have your own gifts. And so I'd love to hear, let's start with Allison, what your thoughts are about comparing yourself. And I'd like to also invite everybody who's in the chat to chat. You know, Laura, when Allison's talking, I'm seeing you chatting. Great. Thank you so much. And anybody in the chat, if you would like to ask our panel questions, we'd love to see your question. And we do have an open seat. Tammy has been really working to bring herself on and has not been able to, and all is well. So if anybody else wants to raise their hand and see if we can get that seat filled to ask a question, we would love to have you just raise your hand and say, hey, I'd like to join. So Allison, why don't you go ahead and start with the, what do you do? How do you support your people when they start comparing themselves to you or to other people out there, and start to quell their pioneering spirit?
Well, I think for any issue, topic, challenge, I always start with the vibrational aspect of it, because I believe we live in a vibrational universe. And if somebody's comparing themselves to other people, my first question would be, how's that making you feel? Because whatever you're feeling is the vibe that you're putting out into the world. And typically, if you're comparing yourself to somebody else, you're typically seeing yourself as less than whatever they are. And that certainly is not a good vibe. And so I start there. It's like, first of all, what vibe does that put you in? And if that's not putting you in a high-flying vibe, then clearly it's not resonant with the most powerful part of you, which is your inner being, your spirit, your intuition, and all of that. So anything we feel that's out of resonance with that deeper part of us will throw us off our vibe. And secondly, and so my advice on that is, if it's not serving you, then ditch it, you know, so why even bother comparing yourself? But secondly, you can't compare yourself to anybody. You're a unique human being. You're doing your own thing, in, and you just got to do you the way you were meant to do you. And whatever, when you are fully 100% authentically yourself, I actually just did a show on needing the approval of others. You can find a videotape of that on AllisonPhillips.tv. But a lot of that comes from not having that self-love. Like, if you feel like you're 100% completely worthy and that you are fully capable of doing whatever you want, you don't fall into the trap of comparing yourself to others, because you know that you are unique, you are divine, you are awesome, you are powerful, you're brilliant, and you fully embrace that, and you're so loving you that you don't look at what other people are doing, because you trust that whatever you're called to do is magnificent and perfect just the way it is, and wherever you are is just fine, and you'll get to wherever you need to be by simply being a vibrational attractor of whatever experience that you want to have in life. I'm done.
Well said, Allison.
Beautiful. Thank you, Allison. All right, Laura, it's on you now on comparing. Have you ever compared yourself to others? Yeah. Or have you ever worked with your clients and helped them when they've been either comparing themselves to others or to you?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, and to me, it's what I talked about earlier with that. To me, it's a gift because they are just reflecting back and igniting something in me, because it happens, or my clients, looking at what exactly is it, breaking it down. What exactly is it that's, you know, triggering me, or if I'm comparing some, you know, something. But, you know, one of the things I want to say is a little bit different take. Is I work with a lot of creative thought leaders and who are pioneers. And actually, lots of times it's lonely out there, you know, as a pioneer, that, you know, there might be one or two people and you might compare, but usually you are forging ahead and there's a lot of people behind you who haven't caught up with your message. And lots of times it can be really a lonely place. And if you aren't well grounded, and I think well supported, you know, with a coach or with working with someone who can keep reminding you of that brilliance and what your mission is, that it's really easy to think, to start playing smaller and say, no, I need to go back here and start doing what they're doing because nobody's understanding me or they don't get me. And so I think a lot of the coaching that I do is helping them bridge that, you know, bridge their pioneering voice and what they're stand for with kind of everybody might not have caught up yet. So how do they bridge that together?
Beautiful. I want to just mention, first of all, hi, Cammy, we got you. You did it. Allison, you're going to have to drop out and come back in again because I'm only getting your audio. And I got to say, oh, my God, Craig Carpenter. He has a really powerful comment here in the comment stream. It says, I feel like social media has amplified the issue because we now live in a world of curated success. It's sometimes hard to remember that everyone has their challenges that are not on the surface. And now all three of you ladies have gone only to audio. So everybody drop off and come back on again. We're going to try again to get you back on. Allison.
I think that's such a
kick Laura here, and we're going to kick Cammy, and let's see if we can get everybody to come back on again. So there's Laura and there's Cammy, and dear technology angels, please facilitate it so that all of my beautiful babes can be seen and heard. There's Laura. Mm-hmm. She's back. Yay. Laura's back. Mm-hmm. Okay, great.
So Cammy, and that's what I, you know, I love what Craig's pointing out. If I can jump in. About the curated success.
Yeah,
please. You know, one of the things that I tell my clients is, and I heard this one time, is, you know, don't compare your, you know, your behind the scenes footage with somebody else's, you know, movie role, you know, like they're real. It's like, you know, they're bringing the best out there on Facebook and the best on their website. And you're not seeing all the take ones, take two, take 24s, you know, and, you know, what happened to prepare and, you know, get to that point, and their mindsets and beliefs and, you know, maybe the meltdowns that they had, you know, before they got to the video that looks really brilliant and really beautiful. So you really do have to be, you know, you don't want to be comparing somebody's outward appearance with your inner junk going on.
Oh, yum. That was so good. So good, Laura. So I want to welcome Cammy. Hi, Cammy. Yay.
Hi.
I love your perseverance. Perseverance rocks. So thank you so much, Cammy, for being here. And Allison, we'd love to have you go ahead and see if you can rejoin us as well. So Cammy, I would love to have you introduce yourself. Tell us a little bit about you. Talk briefly about what pioneering means to you, business success means to you, and if you have anything to say about competition or comparing, or if you have questions for either Laura, myself, or Allison, we'd love to have you just express. Part of the intent for Babes on Blab is not only to have this be a platform for leaders, but also for it to be a platform for emerging leaders. And so I totally see you as an emerging leader, Cammy, and I'm super glad that you're here today and made it and were perseverant. So please go ahead and ask or share. Please go ahead and share what you have, what you've come to share with us today.
Awesome. Well, you were breaking up a little bit there, but I think what you want to hear is my name is CammieBaker.com, and it has been for many years. I started out in real estate just like Amethyst did. And I'm really enjoying what the ladies are having to say. You know, Allison was talking about, you know, having that spiritual change and being very hard to go back to doing business the way we used to do it. You know, going from business as fear into business as love and prosperity. My journey right now is that I have become the priestess of perpetual happiness with my mentorship with Amethyst. Over the last year, we've been mentoring together and gone on trips to Costa Rica and just had a great time getting to know myself spiritually. And for those of you who are on the webinar today, who are maybe where I am with lots of great ideas, wanting to pioneer, having paradigm changes that you want to share with others, and maybe just getting started with it, just know that, you know, I do think about the competition thing, and it's been very challenging for me to come up with valuing myself and my business. And I've realized that there is no competition. You know, when I'm in real estate and I'm competing with other commissions, or when I own my bar and it was how much does somebody charge for a beer, that's competition. But when it's us and it's our intellectual real estate, it's me and all the things that I've acquired over the years, it's Amethyst, it's Laura, it's, you know, we're all so individual. How can it be competition? Period. It just can't.
Oh, I'm back. Everyone's quiet. Is everybody?
All right. We lost Cammie, but that's awesome. She made it on. And are you there? Allison is back. And thank you, ladies, so much for being so willing to play the game on, like, really, we're pioneering here.
Can't
we're
hear you, Amethyst.
We're pioneering.
Is that okay. Just me?
Can you come back in, Laura? And Allison, can you hear me?
I can hear you just fine.
Okay, great. So we're going to try them again, and we're going to say thank you so much to Cammie for coming in and talking and sharing her message. And I have another brief commercial break. Let's take a stretch. Everybody stretch. Stretch. Because you're stretching. Stretching. Everybody stretch. Shake it out. Let it go. Everybody stretch. Oh my God. We are really stretching here because I'm actually periscoping over here at the same time. I have a periscope.
Multi-video tasking.
Yeah, whatever. I told the periscope people, I said, don't expect me to engage over here and over here because that's not happening. brief commercial break. First off, I want to say thank you to everybody who's in the chat who is chatting away. You guys rock. Thank you for sharing this with your followers on Twitter. Please check out babesonblab.com to find out more about how to get on our mailing list and to find out about the next episode. The next episode is going to be happening on the 30th, which is 2 weeks from today. My plan is to do this every other Wednesday at 1 o'clock in the afternoon. Please to put out the hashtag babesonblab, #babesonblab. And if you really are getting something out of this conversation, we want to know. We want to know if you're getting value, if you're receiving value from our time here together today, because that is definitely our intention. Thank you to everybody who's like really super engaged in the chat. I am loving seeing all of the chat that's going on. And I have one more question to ask my wonderful guests here, and that's about camouflaging. So we talked about competition, we talked about comparing ourselves, and now I'd like to talk about camouflaging. Have you ever put on the camouflage, intended to be something other than you were, Or have you ever worked with your clients to help them come out from behind the veil, to come out of hiding, to really more fully express their true colors? And so, Laura, I'd love to start with you, if you could share.
Well, I mean, that's the main work that I do, is help, I guess, I hadn't thought about it as camouflage, but definitely getting to that authentic message that, I mean, it is amazing how difficult that is, you know, to be who you truly are, that it's an incredible, it's incredibly vulnerable and takes so much more courage than it is to try to put up the camouflage and try to be like everybody else as opposed to you. So I would say absolutely, you know, that I feel like that's the more that we can shed those veils, you know, that camouflage us. And I think the more work you do, those veils become thinner and thinner, you know, and sometimes it's just this little teeny glossy thing in front of you, you know, sheer thing in front of you. But it can make the difference in really genuine connection with your audience, with your readers or viewers or, yeah. And so I think it's, you know, I think at the beginning we kind of do it, maybe a kind of armor, you know, because it's taking such courage to even do a video or to put yourself out there. But, you know, after you do it for years and years, as we've been doing it, you know, you learn that the more vulnerable you are and the more real you are and the more you can let those veils go away and really see the real you, that's what people want. They thirst for it. They so thirst for it.
Mm-hmm. And my other phone is ringing now.
I'll check the messages, Amethyst.
Checklist, please make sure you shut off the phones before you get on Babes on Blab TV. Okay, great. So I'd like to ask Cammy about camouflaging, because once upon a time, a while ago, when I first connected with Cammy, she was working in a network marketing organization, and she had me come in and be part of an event that she was hosting. And she's just a real powerhouse in terms of bringing people together and supporting them in coming into a different reality in their own lives. But at the time, I remember I walked in and I looked, and she was wearing a tan colored dress that literally blended right in with the wall of the hotel, literally blended right in with the, and I loved her to pieces. And I walked up to her and I said, Cammy, why are you in camouflage? Why are you wearing camouflage? And so Cammy, if you want to talk a little bit about that experience and you know, what has shifted for you since then. And Allison, I had to kick you to have you come back in again. Yeah, there we go. Cammy, if you want to talk a little bit about that, that would be awesome.
Well, I just want to thank you, Amethyst, for at the time giving me the title Camouflage Cammy. And, you know, it's funny when people give you a name like that, it really sticks. And so it did make me want to change my wardrobe up a little bit and just be a little more free spirited and have a little bit more fun, because my personality is, you know, every personality chart I look at always says, you know, straight black and white, tan and black, tan and white. And so I really needed to come out of my camouflage cami phase to be able to express myself. And, you know, I've always been a speaker from face to face. I've always done speaking events, whether it was one person or 30,000, face to face with people. And so the whole online and the virtual speaking has been something that, for me, I've had to really search my soul about that, because it almost feels like I'm camouflaging myself by staying home and not going out and shaking hands and being face to face in the public. So, you know, by doing these videos with you ladies today, and just really starting to venture into this form of speaking, I do see that just because I'm not out driving somewhere and spending hours out meeting people and handing out business cards, this is actually a much better way of not being camouflaged. This is a much better way of meeting not just people in a room, but people in the whole country and the whole world. And I just want to thank you, Amethyst, for helping me see that I was camouflaging myself in a lot of ways, not just in the way that I was dressing and holding myself back that way, but also by not giving myself to the world and being able to share my thoughts and feelings and be able to receive so much more love and blessings. I mean, the women that you're having on today are just such a gift. And, you know, as it was being said earlier, I believe it was Laura that said, you know, becoming a pioneer, you start hanging out with pioneers and all of a sudden everybody's so creative and everybody's so wonderful. And that's true. But the more we hang out with each other and have like-minded people around us, the more we can pioneer and the faster we can all become the Homo illuminus species that we are meant to be.
Mm-hmm. Yes, yes, the luminous ones. We are here to be the luminous ones. Okay, so Allison, let's see if we can get you back. Let's see if we, there she is, beautiful Allison. Want to talk about camouflaging?
That's a really awesome topic because I felt like when I had my spiritual awakening 2 years ago, I had a lot of camouflaging going on because I was moving from one belief system to another, and people knew me in one belief system, and I was moving to another set of beliefs about life, and it really became very frustrating for me because I was trying to fit in here and fit in here, and then at a certain point, I realized I just have to be the new me. I can't be the old me anymore. I can't satisfy everybody who wants me to be the old me. I have to be the new me. So quite a bit of camouflaging who I was and what I believed about life. And I tell you, it is the most freeing thing to not care what other people. It is the most freeing thing on this planet. And I actually just did a video on that about not caring about what other people think. You can find it out. But when you realize that you cannot care what other people think, otherwise you are a slave to what they think. And you free yourself when you realize you have to care what other people think. What they think is their business, not mine. What they think happens with who they are, not who I am. And that allowed me to really free myself. I would say I have released all of my camouflages today. It's funny because my daily show that I do on Periscope, I'm probably the only singing, dancing business coach that has a daily show on Periscope. My camouflages have gone. I'm going to do me. Allison sings and dances all day long. That's who I am. I'm a very joyful person, very upbeat. I'm bubbly. That's who I am. And that's who I am on my show, you know? And and it is such a freeing thing to realize that you can be 100% authentically you, and whoever resonates with that will come, and whoever does not resonate with that will find somebody else to resonate with it, and that's totally cool. So I think the experience of trying to please other people was my path to really releasing all of the camouflages and being 100% authentic.
Awesome. So everybody dance now. Everybody get up. We're going to have a little dance party, little babes on blab. Everybody dance now. All right. Dancing. We're dancing. We're babes on blab. We're dancing. We're talking business. We're talking success. We're singing badly, and that's okay. All is well. Everybody dance now. And I have my sisters with me here. So thank you, Allison, thank you, Laura, and I want to share a little bit about camouflage, because I think it's really something that we can actually elevate and use at another level. For me, what I have discovered in my pioneering about camouflage is I want to be completely transparent and fully present and absolutely seen and heard and connected to my divine people. And I want to be completely invisible to anyone who is not my divine people. In fact, I want to actually be repellent to anyone who is not my divine people, because energetically, to me, it's much more efficient to be repellent and to clear the space of energy of anything that is not going to be resonant, any beings that are not going to be in service to the elevation of my divine destiny and the divine destiny of the people that I'm here to serve. And it's like, let me be repellent so they get out the way, get out the way, get out the way, so that my actual people, that when I'm emanating my vibration, my people are going to unmistakably be able to like lock on to that vibration, and they are going to come forward, and we're going to connect, and we're going to do the magic juju things that we're supposed to be doing together. And we're efficient. It's all efficient. I'm super into being efficient. I am not into casting a wide net and having a giant herd of people, three quarters of whom are not my people. I would much rather repel those people and be very much more attracting the people that are the right people for me to be serving. So I actually now employ camouflage as a energetic tactic, strategy, when I go into places and spaces, or when I go out into the world, and I camouflage to anyone who is not going to be in alignment with or resonant with my gifts and my work that's in the world. So that's one of the ways that I have shifted my relationship with the whole idea of camouflage. Awesome. Well, ladies, it is almost the top of the hour. This has been freaking rocking awesome that you guys were here with me. I'm so grateful to Allison and Laura and Cammie and everyone who was in the Lab Chat, who has come to be present here. I am a spiritual babe, as well as being a very successful business babe. And all of my babe friends are both spiritual and successful. So I want to give you ladies a Golden Path card from the Wisdom of the Golden Path. I love to play with oracles. And so everybody's going to get a card today who came to be on my show. And I definitely want to set up a TTT, time to talk more with you, Allison and Laura and Cammie, and explore how we can take this little party and really elevate it to the next level over time. So this one is for Allison. Allison, you received wings of light. Look at that. Look at that, babe. Wings of light. Gorgeous. That is for Allison. Allison gets wings of light. And Laura, you are getting, and while we're drawing cards, I want to let everybody, remind everybody to go to babesonblab.com to find out more about when our next episode is airing, to join our community, to support the Babes on Blab, and to find out other fun stuff that we have going on there. So Laura got prosperity freedom. Yay, Laura, prosperity freedom. Go girl, like that. You got prosperity freedom. We love that. We'll take wings of light and prosperity freedom. Woohoo! And Cammie, this one's for you. So I have to say, first off, big, big props to you, Cammie, for putting yourself out there and getting out from behind your camouflage. Also, I have to say, thank you, Cammie, for investing in yourself through me. And thank you to all of my clients who've invested in themselves through me and my work, because without clients like you who are focused and dedicated and invested and highly committed to bringing yourself out of camouflage, out of the closet, and to be getting into your role, to really step into your role in the world as an empowered messenger, there's no way I could be doing what I'm doing right now. So honor and appreciation and love and gratitude to my client, Cammie, for being here. Also, I'm sure to Allison and Laura's clients, they also feel that same level of gratitude. And so, Cammie, oh, this is a good card for you. Self-worth. Cammie's card is self-worth. And if at the end of the day, Babes on Blab TV can help even one woman, even one, to own her self-worth, it will all have been worth it. So we are going to say thank you, thank you, thank you to Allison, Laura, and Cammie. If you ladies just want to say bye and give your URLs really quickly one more time, I am at theempoweredmessenger.com. And please also go over to Babes on Blab to support our mission here.
Allison, thank you.
You want to go ahead and give us your,
thank you. It's fun.
Where people can find you.
Oh, type it in.
She's very fun.
Laura?
Thanks for being a pioneer of pioneers, Amethyst.
Cammie
Baker. Thanks, everybody.
Thank you, everyone.
Okay.
Thank you.
So just stick it over there in the chat.
Okay.
We're being pioneers. All right, ladies. Thank you. Mwah. It was a pleasure. I so appreciate you. Be well. Thank you to our audience. Thank you to everybody who was here. Look for the replays. Thank you, Laura. Thank you, Allison. Let's get together and talk again soon. This is Amethyst Wildfire with theempoweredmessenger.com and Babes on Blab TV. Please join us again in 2 weeks for our episode on spirituality. And we are going to have another two amazing guests who are going to be part of our Babes on Blab TV spirituality show. And I can't wait to see who shows up and gets served. Thank you. Be well. Bye. Okay, let's see.